A woman has 21 coins in her pocket, all of which are dimes and quarters. If the total value of her change is $3.90, how many dimes and how many quarters does she have? So for this problem, we're going to set up a system of equations and then solve it algebraically. Notice that we don't know the number of dimes or the number of quarters, so we'll assign variables for these amounts. Let's let x equal the number of dimes, and we'll let y equal the number of quarters. The first sentence states that the woman has 21 coins in her pocket. So if x is the number of dimes and y is the number of quarters, this would give us the equation x plus y must equal 21. Next, we're told the total value of the change is $3.90. Well, every dime is worth 10 cents, and every quarter is worth 25 cents. So if we write the value equation in cents, we can avoid decimals. So the value from the dimes is going to be 10 cents times x plus the value of the quarters is going to be 25 cents times y, and this must equal $3.90, which would be 390 cents. Again, we're using cents to avoid having decimals in our equations. And now to solve this system of equations algebraically, we can either use the substitution method or the elimination method. If we want to use the elimination method, we want to add these two equations and either eliminate the x terms or the y terms. The only way that's going to occur is if the x terms or y terms are opposites. So if we wanted to eliminate the x terms, we would want this first term here to be negative 10x. So what we'll do is multiply the first equation by negative 10, then leave the second equation the same. So we're going to multiply this entire equation by negative 10. That's going to give us negative 10x minus 10y equals 21 times negative 10 would be negative 210. We'll leave the second equation the same. So we have 10x plus 25y equals 390. And now when we add these equations together, since the x terms are opposites, this sum would be 0. So we're left with 15y must equal negative 210 plus 390, which is equal to 180. Now we'll divide both sides by 15. And so we have y equals 180 divided by 15 is equal to 12. And since y is equal to 12, this means we have 12 quarters, and now we have to determine how many dimes we have. So we can use the equation x plus y equals 21 and substitute 12 for y. So we'd have x plus 12 equals 21. Subtract 12 on both sides. So we have x equals 9. So this tells us we have 9 dimes and 12 quarters. Notice how this gives us 21 coins, and 9 times 10 cents plus 12 times 25 cents would give us a total of $3.90. Now let's also verify this graphically. Remember, if we graph these two linear equations on the same coordinate plane, the point of intersection would represent the solution. So here's the equation x plus y equals 21. And here's the equation 10x plus 25y equals 390. Therefore, this point of intersection represents our solution, where the x-coordinate represents the number of dimes, which is 9, and the y-coordinate represents the number of quarters, which is 12. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.